finite and non-finite verbs. A verb that is limited by the number, the person, of the subject, the tense, is called a finite verb. A verb that is not limited by the number, the person, of the subjects, the tense, is called a non-finite verb. Try to understand with the examples. They play football. He plays football. You are playing football. She is playing football. She was playing football. In these examples, they play. Play is a finite verb because it agrees with they. And second example, he plays. It agrees. Plays agree with he, with the subject. So it is a finite verb. You are is a finite. She is a finite. And she was is a finite. It is. It agrees with the subject as well as it is telling the tense, which tense it is. Things to observe. Each verb has its subject. The form of the verb depends on its subject. Each verb is limited by the number, person, of the subject, and its tense. Non-finite verb. They like to play football. The verb in yellow is a, you could say, non-finite verb. He likes to play football. She is playing football. He was playing football. They have always liked to play football. Things to observe here. For example, in the first example, they like to play football. Like is a finite verb because like agrees with they, but to play does not agree with they. It is far from the subject. It is infinitive. What is infinitive? We will understand in another example. Non-finite verb can be the infinitive, gerund, and participle. Infinitive means to. After to, when we apply first form of verb in a sentence, it does not have any concern with the subject. It can appear in past, present, and future tense. For example, the students like to join our club. The students like. Like is a finite, but to join is non-finite. Why? Because to join does not have any concern with the student subject. It is easy to criticize others. To criticize is a non-finite. Similar to win. The captain hopes to win the game. The girl is too sick to walk. To walk is a non-finite again. And in the last example, the children have come to see the school. To see is a non-finite verb. Now it is a participle verb. Participle can be present participle and past participle. And in ing or shows an action in a sentence or incomplete. The past participle ends in ed, d, t, or en, or n. Shows an action as completed. The present participle, I saw the thief stealing money. Stealing is a non-finite verb which is in purple color. I can hear him laughing. So in the first example, I saw the thief stealing. I saw. So is a finite verb because it agrees with subject I, but stealing does not agree with I. So similarly, in present participle, all the purple color is stealing, laughing, moving, seeing, rising, playing, seeing, considering, being, stealing are present participle non-finite verbs. Another example in past participle, deceived by his brother. He sought justice from the court. So deceived by his brother, deceived, ed or en or n or d, if it comes, if verb appears in this in purple color, so this is a non-finite verb in past participle. Number one, deceived, and number two example, torn. Three, lost, worried, stolen, disappeared, disappointed, learned, blinded, driven, and gone, driven, gone. These are the past participle non-finite verb. The gerund is a non-finite verb, ends in ing, works like a noun. Gerunds are nouns made by verbs and in ing. Jogging is a good exercise. Jogging does not tell any tense that it is a past, present, or future. So this is the gerund, ing form. It is being used. The verb, it is in black, is they are all from 1 to 10 gerund. Reading is his hobby. Similarly, eating, running, playing, watching, dying, flying, fighting, all these are called gerund. Studying. So, thanks for watching. Hope you got it.